to the ring from Mexico, Uriel Lopez.
Here he comes, Uriel Lopez. This fella was involved in one of my favourite recent fights with Mark McKeon. That happened last December up in Renton. Mark, if you're listening, thank you for that. It was an absolute barnstormer, but Uriel Lopez played his part as well. And if we get half as much entertainment in this one, we're in for a real treat. He's a former opponent of Emmanuel Navarrete, and although he's currently on an 8-fight losing streak, this Mexican does not come to roll over. He will throw leather, and Mr. McGrail will have to be on his ear again. Dancing in the moonlight for the 25-year-old 2020 Olympian, making the walk to the professional ring for the fourth time. Previous two of the three also being in this very arena of his home city, Liverpool. It's a Commonwealth Games gold medalist, and in 2017 he picked up top honours at the European Championships. Seven-time national champion. There's many, especially in these parts, that think he's the best out of the bunch when it comes to the team that went to the Olympics for Team GB, placing high expectations on the young Scouser's shoulders. Looking forward to seeing him in action tonight. Let's get the official introductions in a moment after the tail of the tape. Uriel Lopez, only 2 years the senior of McGrail. Very even right across the board. Let's get into the ring, shall we? And get the official introductions from Melissa Santos.
The following contest is set for 8 rounds of boxing in the super bantamweight division. Introducing first to my left, fighting out of the blue corner from Mexico, weighing in at 124 pounds. He has 15 wins as a professional, 7 are by way of knockout.
Take a step back, no punches in the back of the head. Protect yourselves at all times. Touch gloves.
Right, here we go. Joe McGrail earlier on was absolutely fantastic, and I've no doubt that Paul Smith will shed some light on this. When the brothers box on the same card, there'll probably be a bit of banter backstage as to who did the best second performance. Tonight is the opportunity for Peter McGrail to make a bit of a statement, because Uriel Lopez is absolutely no mug. A seasoned journeyman, no doubt, but he comes to throw down, and maybe that might present an opportunity or two for Peter McGrail to go through the repertoire. Great. Straight left to the body to start us off.
We all saw what Lopez did in Rainton in his fight with Mark McGeon. It was an absolute cracker. I think Peter McGrail is a different type of fighter and may not let Lopez settle to even land many shots, as we can see already the class footwork from Peter McGrail.
Really good stuff from McGrail. That backhand landing for fun. But you can just see oozing class and confidence. McGrail seems to be comfortable at all different types of ranges.
stopped.
Good work from McGrail.
You can see that Team GB pedigree, can't you? Just rolls in, lands, throws a big shot, splits off to the side.
Out the back door.
Yeah.
Lovely uppercut there from McGrail.
Nice. I think lovely choppy left hand as well.
Seems to be finding the target relatively easy through the first couple of minutes of this one. But again, it all comes back to what you were saying earlier on, Paul, in commentary of previous fights. It's all down to his feet. It's all about where he is.
Fundamentals of boxing is what you're taught from day one when you go into a boxing gym. The base and the foundations of your footwork, they should be evident, and then you build on that. Just landed another lovely little left hand there, Peter McGrail.
That was a beautiful left hand.
Lopez felt that,
no doubt about it. Beautiful shot. Mixing it up as well. Those straight shots seems to be the money at the moment, whether they go upstairs or downstairs. The straight ones are the ones doing the business.
You always see fighters like McGrail, you see fighters like the one of my generation was always Richie Woodall, he was a textbook amateur.
Yeah.
You couldn't tell someone to watch Peter McGrail and do what he does because it's so difficult to do, you know what I mean? He just makes it look effortless, he makes it look easy. The way he's moving and the way he's positioning them feet at the moment, it's absolutely class.
Really good work there from McGrail.
When you see someone like this fight, who has a real understanding of range, it's a joy to watch, because it's only the movements that they make are millimeters. It's just the tiniest of movements. It might not even resonate on the television screen, but whilst you're here and you're up close and personal with it, it's just a tiny little movement. He's out of the way.
Yeah, just bouncing there on his feet, trademark of the amateur game, just in and out. Lopez got no idea where the range is. Unfortunately, he's getting hit with two and three shots, and then when he does try and throw back against any other fighter, he may well catch something if you get lucky. McGrail's gone. He's either gone out the back door, or he's just took that little step backwards, and he's out of range again, you know?
Some of the best fighters I've ever seen live in a boxing ring, and I've been lucky to see a few, and if this isn't about me, this is about my opinion on what I think. Your Lomachenko from the corner, Canelo from the corner twice, I've been in the ring with Andre Ward. The best thing about those fighters is how they cover the ground effortlessly.
Yep. Yeah.
They make it look easy. Lomachenko in particular, along with Usyk.
Usyk does it as
well,
yeah.
They just do it so simple. They cover the ground so easy.
How bad is it when you're in with one of them?
Oh. It was painfully brilliant, if you know what I mean.
You turned into a fan?
Yeah. He hit me with a jab, and I remember giggling to myself, how have you just hit me with that?
you were miles away 2 seconds ago, where are you?
Peter McGrail, just cut this one.
Yeah.
He's known as the Scouse Lomachenko. Oh!
And then returns one himself.
And he has that movement also. He can cover the ground easily. He makes it look effortless when he's in there.
Good return,
lovely,
from Peter McGrail, after catching one himself.
Those type of shots, what he's just caught, they may want to...
Beautiful left hand from McGrail.
They may want to make him stay in the pocket and think, well, you can have some back now.
Yeah.
Really good stuff from McGrail. He's got the timing down to a T. He's going through the repertoire. Uriel Lopez's game, he wants to throw back, he switches his own stance into southpaw. Now he's back into orthodox. He's a tough Mexican, this fella.
He's took some flush and he's still coming.
Listen, Mark McKeon hitting with some flush shots as well up in range. Another big round, left hand! McGrail looking to unload! Jeez! Lopez's chin, absolutely rock solid. But he's taking him flush. Really good work from McGrail, switching the angle there, just going on the outside and then coming back in. Really good stuff, creating different angles, giving Lopez something to think about. But when he puts those combinations together, it's fast and it is ferocious. And it's only going to take one to land really clean. To go, and again, just takes a little step back the Mexican, but here he comes. Doesn't matter what stance you stand in, he's going to clip you.
He's got some poker face, Lopez. He hasn't opened his mouth once this round. He hasn't changed that gaze and that stare. I'm sure he will when the bell goes and he walks back to his corner. It's been a torrid round for him so far.
Just a little bit of a grimace there. That was the first time he's seen any kind of change in his face.
I'll tell you what, ever since Lopez clipped McGrail at the start of this round, he has just gone through the gears and put a clinic on. Really good stuff from Peter McGrail.
And again, you know, we've mentioned this two or three times tonight now when we're suggesting for younger fighters to just relax and let it flow.
Yeah.
Look how he just relaxes and lets these shots go on McGrail.
And this is why Peter McGrail in his fourth professional fight having an eight rounder, because he's ready. He's ready to move up. The next one will be a 10 rounder.
I'm just watching Lopez make his way back to his corner. It was a zigzag, it wasn't a straight line. He came a little bit zigzaggy in. He puffed his cheeks out, looks at his corner, he says, "What is this?" Fantastic stuff, really good stuff. Talk us through the action, boys, because after getting that little bit of a choppy left hand, he went through the gears.
That was the footwork, he just steps out of range. Lopez falls short, he makes Lopez fall short, McGrail, and then lands a nice chopping left hand right on the target. And then, as I said, in Jordan that round, that shot that McGrail was caught with may have been sort of the wake-up call, because he was boxing fine.
Yeah.
But he might just think, well, you know what, you can have a few more now, and I'm willing to stay in the pocket because I felt your power and it wasn't much, so let's go.
Yeah, I'm going to put it on you. And that's what we've seen there. He went through the gears, didn't he? He went through the gears in that round.
Yeah, really good to watch.
Suddenly Lopez now agreeing to do eight rounds with McGrail. It feels like a mountain to climb.
Well, here we go. Here's the third of them. Switched his stances a couple of times, did Uriel Lopez, throughout the course of that second phase. But he's back in his orthodox stance now, matching up against the southpaw in the black shorts of Peter McGrail. Beautiful left hand. He's going through the gears here, is Peter McGrail. Little touchdown. Oh. Into the neutral corner. I think just a little bit of miscommunication. McGrail was going through the motions there as the knee did touch down from Uriel Lopez. Not just down as a knockdown. But here we go. Let's get the action back on. McGrail. Really good shot once again from McGrail, who lands that big left hand. And again, I said right at the start of the fight, the straight ones are the ones doing the business, but now the ones coming around the side are doing the business as well. Really good repertoire from Peter McGrail, who mixes it up, goes downstairs.
Head's coming close there. What do you do to beat Peter McGrail if you're Lopez?
Yeah.
Do you try and absorb this for three or four more rounds and hope he tires? Because at the moment, that looks like it's the only answer. Try and make him outwork himself, make him punch himself out. Because every time Lopez throws, he's being made to miss. He's not missing, he's being made to miss. And the footwork of McGrail and the class that he's showing is what's doing that.
Big uppercut from McGrail once again. I don't know about you boys, but the best way to describe McGrail, right?
Oh,
that's a big left hand! He hits it though, did Uriel Lopez. He's got some chin on him. He is taking some serious punishment through the first three. And again.
Listen, I know it's not.
The corner needs to have a little bit of a look
Lopez,
in a minute.
But we're watching something special with Peter McGrail.
My goodness. A little choppy uppercut on side that he throws, that left hand, lovely.
Peter McGrail is going through the repertoire. I was just about to describe him as, do you know, like when you're in a beer garden on a hot summer's day and there's a wasp flying around your pint and you just can't get rid of it? He's like that. He is on you constantly. And he's going through the whole back catalog. Big left hand from McGrail. Lopez must certainly felt that one. He has a little bit of a look through squinted eyes at McGrail and says, okay, I'll go southpaw for a minute. I'll tell you something, boys. If this goes on for another 6 minutes after this, if Lopez is still here, his corner's got to have a look at this. Because what's the point? He is getting his pants pulled down.
Taking so many shots, flush Lopez.
And again. It's an unbelievable display of mastering range and hand speed. McGrail. He got...
got an overhand left in the second round, which just made him check himself a touch. And ever since that moment, McGrail has just gone, right, OK, we'll go from second into fourth and we'll put a foot down a touch.
Even this slow-mo, it just started with a little push out of range from McGrail. And he steps back in, lets his own hands go. The minute Lopez starts to throw, he just pushes out of range where he's safe. And it's all from the feet and the footwork and the lateral movement of McGrail. You see the step out of range, he just jumps out of range a few inches to come back and counter.
Paul, even tiny little old man things like that, just the use of the shoulder to for the separation, there, bang, out the way, and the shot's there for him.
That's
mature.
Years. Yeah, that's years and years and years of top quality bouts in the amateurs against other fellow national champions from all the best countries around the world, and then camps with all your fellow peers, like the GB team and other countries flying into Spartan.
Yeah.
He's learned every bit of it and he's carried it into the professional game.
Got to give Lopez his credit though. He is game, this fella. Like I said, we saw him up in Renton against Mark McKeown. Didn't take a backward step that night. Mark McKeown got the job done against him in a real belter of a fight. And for different reasons, this is a real belter of a fight as well, because, as Paul said a moment or two ago, you're witnessing something very, very special. I know it's only early in his career, but as an elite amateur, a lot of people have been excited about Peter McGrail and what he could do in the pros. And he's showing you that he's levels above Uriel Lopez at the moment. And I won't be surprised, as Nick said a moment or two ago, if he's sped along the touch. And we're seeing him in 10 rounders very, very quickly.
I think the 10 rounder next, absolutely. And your top mounts, you know, mentioned it earlier on the broadcast, British and Commonwealth title opportunities, if not by the end of the year, certainly early into 2023. There's no good waiting with him. You know, we've seen it at the next level with Lomachenko, moved into a world title fight in his second professional fight. Maybe not quite that quickly, but British and Commonwealth inside six or seven fights, absolutely for Peter McGrail, because you can just see how quality is and imagine how destructive.
Big right hand from McGrail. Lopez just checked himself for a second, but he's still there.
You see the little push out of range game from McGrail. Whenever Lopez commits to attack, he just pushes out the range 6 inches and just nullifies and stops everything Lopez is doing to come back with counters then like this.
Really good work from Peter McGrail. Really good work from Peter McGrail.
He looks so sharp as a pro as well.
Oh, big left hand again as he looks to tee off. He can smell the finish in that one. It's a sensational barrage. Lopez, has his heart been broken? He's having a look. He's thinking about it. He gets up. Steve Gray's waved it off, rightfully so. Great refereeing from Steve Gray. Listen, we're hypercritical of officials sometimes in this game. Steve Gray's made the right decision there, because that is only going one way. You didn't need to see any more. You saw enough. Peter McGrail going through the repertoire and giving the fans here in Liverpool an absolute treat, gents.
Yeah, the Lopez corner remonstrating a bit there, but just look at the replay, you know. Absolutely sensational stuff from McGrail.
I think the referee's made the right decision, but I can see the argument. He got up on eight, his faculties are all there. He's certainly not, you know, dazed and rocked and can't stand up, but he's took far too many punches.
Yeah.
And you don't want to see that. It's better to have an early stoppage than a late stoppage, so I fully agree with Steve Gray.
It was the fact that it wasn't one clean punch that put him down, it was momentum. He chose to go down.
He went down, yeah.
And
exactly.
He chose to get up very, very late. That means he's had enough, you know, his heart's breaking, I've had enough now. And it's only the will in the man that's made him get back to his feet. I think it's a great decision by Steve Gray to pull him out.
And it's the corner that's got to save him, or the referee in the corner we're never going to save him.
Absolutely.
Absolutely. I think, like I said, we're hypercritical of officials when they get it wrong. We've got to praise them when they get it right. I think he got that absolutely bang on, Steve Gray. Right decision. Peter McGrail was going through the gears and it was only going one way. Great performance from Peter. Exciting times ahead for him, Nick. No doubt, mate.
I'll tell you what.
You might be right.
We've seen tons of Scouts talent on this undercard tonight. I'm delighted to say the future is golden. But I tell you what, the future for Liverpool boxing is standing right there. Peter McGrail, absolutely phenomenal. World titles in his future, 100%.
And that's coming from a Scouser, and he's not being biased, I promise you. I'm not a Scouser, I feel the same way. Right, let's get this all official, shall we, with Melissa Santos.
Referee Steve Gray, stop the fight at 2:03 in the fourth round. For your winner by technical knockout, Peter McGrail!
Cannot argue with that. 4 wins in his professional tenure, 3 of them coming via the way of the stoppage. And from the second round onwards, well, he was in the rhythm from the first round, if we're really honest, but from the second round, he just got clipped with the left hand, and it just seemed to go, hang on a minute, you're not supposed to hit me back. Right, OK, then, I'll show you what this is all about, Sunshine. We're going to go through the levels. The footwork was on point, the mastering of range was sensational, the hand speed, just everything about what Peter McGrail did in that. OK, we get the level of opponent, but that just wets the whistle of what could come next.
Exactly. That was his first 8 round there. There was no way it was ever going to go 8 rounds. I tell you what a prospect this guy is. Get him in a 10 rounder, get him in a title fight before the end of the year, because he's ready. He's got the pedigree, Adam, to go all the way. There's no point hitting the brakes with this kid. He's off the leash now. It's about matching him up, and that's going to be the difficult part, because nobody's going to want a piece of Peter McGrail anytime soon.
Just getting his t-shirt on for the sponsors, you see. He's about to do his TV interview. You've got to get the sponsors on the telly, lad. That's what it's all about. He's ringside with Radio Raheem.
Peter. Here. Are you standing? It would be hard to know that this was only your 4th fight, looking at the display you put on tonight. Such technical proficiency. How did you become so good so fast?
Listen, it's not just me. It's obviously the lads in the gym as well. We're being trained under Paul Stevenson and Anthony Humphries now. I've been in our gym every time since I was 10, and every single day I go in, I learn something new, and I'm going to continue to do that over the next, whatever it is, 10 to 12 years of my career, and just going to keep getting better and better, and hopefully in the future there's going to be big nights coming to Liverpool for me. And obviously you had the lads on it, Joe, Frankie, Harry Kinney, all where all the next stop coming through, and we're going to be bringing world title belts to Liverpool, because I know that Scousers love boxing, and that's what we're here for, to bring big nights to the echo.
You scheduled an 8 rounder tonight. Your opponent Lopez didn't have any intention of going anywhere. Give me the idea of how you broke him down. What was the technique?
Listen, I was just working the body, working the edge, slipping, throwing the backhand, using my variation of my shots, so we didn't really know what was coming. But sometimes some people are too tough for their own good, and some corners are too leave the box in there too long. But credit to Lopez, he took a lot of damage there, and he was still in there, he was still standing. But I think it was a good decision that the ref stopped the fight, because he was only going to carry on taking more shots and more of a beating.
If I could bring Sam Jones in, there were names ringside bouted about, like Lomachenko, like Ward. What kind of fighter do we have standing next to us in the future of this man?
First of all, that was a great decision by the referee to stop that. He was taking a pounding. This kid is going to sell this arena out very, very soon. He's going to win world titles in numerous different weight classes. This is a special, special talent. Get behind him, because he's going to sell this out many, many times. What a fighter.
We've had a great opportunity to watch a man in the very beginning of his career. Great things to come. Radio Raheem with Peter McGrail.